Be sure to join Dana Hersey Monday night at 8 o'clock on the Movie Loft for East of Eden, our next Bruins telecast, Thursday night in the Adams Division Finals. This has been a TV 38 sports presentation.
Does Japan play fair with her most important trading partner? Will the U.S. be forced to reciprocate with import quotas and protectionist policy? You should know. It's your business.
Washington, D.C., the United States Chamber of Commerce presents It's Your Business, a weekly series of debates on vital issues affecting you. And now the moderator of It's Your Business, Merrill Comer.
Welcome. The political pressures of recession spawning 9% unemployment and high interest rates.
If you'd like a transcript of today's debate, write to the same address, enclose $1 to cover handling. It's Your Business is produced by the Chamber of Commerce of the United States, publishers of Nation's Business and Washington Report. This has been a production of BizNet, the American Business Network.
The Boston Red Sox play the Baltimore Orioles in a doubleheader. We hope Saturday afternoon at 1 on TV 38. Chance to ask TV 38's Vice President and General Manager, Joseph C. Dimino, questions about TV 38 and or the broadcasting industry in general. Ask the Manager is pre-recorded. And now, here's Joe Dimino.
And here again, just like old. Hello, we're back. This is our 777th show.
Sure, something like that.
Anyway, you know, Dana, our policy has always been to get right to it, because a lot of people have been congratulating us on our...
Name two.
A person congratulated
yes.
me
yes.
About the way we've been answering the mail lately, and I thought we'd do it really and continue that pace.
Well, that's sort of the idea of this program, to impart as much information as we can about television.
Not always
broadcast
accurate.
Broadcast industry in general. Not always
but
accurate.
But information. We just throw it out. We answer anything.
You better believe it. We got, you know, I have to mention Mailbag is in, and all these wonderful... thank you. Easter cards that came in. We have to acknowledge them because, after all, this is Easter, right?
Yes. Happy Easter, everyone.
We really should acknowledge all the wonderful cards from our cable viewers and from our Boston area viewers who sent us these little bunnies.
Mm, good.
Little Easter eggs. And thanks a lot for the chocolate Easter eggs, too, that Cliff eats. All right, here we go. Want to just get right into some mail now? Just
sure.
Move right into it. From Seekonk, Massachusetts. I always thought that was in New Hampshire. Seekonk.
No, it's in my neck of the woods.
It's in up there in Joe's country, near Providence. That's Ray Boyer's own directing. Dear Ask the Manager, dear Joe Dimino, dear Dana Hersey, dear guys, I want to congratulate you and Dana for a very funny show. Watch out, Johnny and Ed. Although I don't catch Lenny Clark as often as I would like to, I'd like to see him... at the Comedy Connection. I feel that his very bright future and whatever in comedy.
Who?
Lenny Clark. My reason for writing is to question the chance of showing on Dana's movie loft, the Russians are coming, or it's a mad, 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 mad world. What do you think?
Well, let me just say, first of all, it's not Dana's movie loft. It's my movie loft, and we allow Dana to walk on the set. I didn't say that you were presuming it was yours. It's not yours. It does have a nice ring to it, though.
It has a nice ring to it.
We could change it. We could change people at the station anytime we want.
And have.
And you're just as expendable as the next guy. You understand that, LG?
Yes, I understand that.
All right,
Some people, as a matter of fact, aren't replaced. They're banished.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, to answer your question, The Russians are coming. It is owned by Channel 56. I know that. Cliffy, you want to do the show for me? It's owned by Channel 56, so we can't run it. But we do own a mad, mad, mad world. And Dana has a policy on my movie loft of wanting to run the very best movies we have available. And if he considers this a good one, he'll run it. He's not going to run anything but the big budget movies because he wants the big ratings, and then he can walk around the station saying he's the cause of the big ratings. So if that movie measures up, Dana will pick it. Dana?
If it's a biggie, we'll always go with the winners, you know what I mean?
Sure.
Okay, for everyday programming, I'd like to know if there's any chance of showing Dobie Gillis?
Not much.
Leave It to Beaver?
Not as long as I'm at this station.
Leave It to Beaver?
Not as long as I'm at this station. But you never know if I were replaced by somebody, what programs they'd pick.
You know,
when Bill Flynn was here, he picked Green Acres.
Right.
With the little pig running around?
Yes, I remember.
That show
Arnold
never made the 6-8 lineup.
Yes, right.
Beverly Hillbillies he picked.
Mm-hmm.
He picked a lot of them. Man from U.N.C.L.E.
Mm-hmm.
Then when I came, we had MASH and Barney Miller.
Right.
Because if I were to leave, the next guy might pick Dobie Gillis.
Well, of course.
Especially a guy like Dan Berkery.
Yes, I would like to say that a guy like Dan Berkery, certainly with that man's incredible intelligence and background, Mr. Berkery would certainly have a flair, I think, for programming, and certainly continue.
You're awfully obsequious. Hmm? And you usually reserve that just for me.
Yeah, I think it's time that we were honest about Mr. Berkery.
You mean the guy who bought the Long Range a half hour and thought they were movies? You mean that fellow?
People make mistakes. You like Ma and Pa Kettle. Sure, nothing can be a winner. But I think Mr. Berkery's a fine man. I'd say that...
He's okay. Let's not push it.
Okay.
Let's continue
on. It would be interesting to have a nostalgia night with some of the old shows. Like, Dana could narrate them.
Dana doesn't do old shows, ladies and gentlemen. He only does the best.
Okay.
Nostalgia night would have to be narrated by Tom Lawson or somebody.
Okay, here we go. Here's...
Boy... You know, you could tell something's brewing because we're really going after each other. The truth will out.
That's good, isn't it? From Scituate, Massachusetts, or Scituate, as they say there, dear BGLG and BBG. BBG? Cliff, no offense. You're a big, big guy. I see. We love your show and the movie loft.
I don't mind him being FBG, but not BBG.
FBG?
Fat big guy.
Okay.
But not big, big guy.
That's...
We get him too today.
Okay, we love your show and the movie loft. Perhaps I should say that again. How about some newer Mueys? Excuse me.
What a class show.
I'm so upset. How about some newer movies? Do you own any of the made-for-television movies like Georgia Peaches?
No.
You sure you didn't buy that one?
No.
Scruples?
No. We lost that deal on those other pictures.
We did lose the picture?
We lose. How long have you been speaking English?
We lost that deal.
If it's not written down for you...
You say lose.
Yeah. If it's not written down for you, you don't say it very well.
Written down?
Written down.
It's not written down for you, Zoe. Okay.
We only have 3 minutes to this segment of the show, mercifully.
Georgia Peaches?
No.
Scruples? Scruples?
No. Do we own Scruples? No.
Kawoos Into Terror?
Yes. We own that. I'm glad you got to that, because I was going to read that first. We get that effective September 1st, 82. And we will run that, and if it's any good, it'll be on the movie loft. By the way, we should congratulate Dana, with all kidding around. We had the rating books came in. I don't think we said anything about this, but the movie loft did a huge number. I mean, since Dana first came on the air and started picking our best movies and most expensive movies, the movies have gone from, like, no ratings to a 6. We get a 6 rating. Dana, it's become a fact, and everybody I run into says, that Dana Hersey really knows a lot of, he's doing a heck of a job. You ought to be proud.
It's, you know, it's wonderful. Just wonderful.
It's a success. We've made that a success, and we're going to continue to put the finest quality features and upgrade the talent on that show.